Bang, don't we? We need to work. What is that?
I'm tweeting.
We're streaming, and you're tweeting?
I'm not even, you know what? I'm not even tweeting about the stream.
You're not even tweeting about the stream. I was making a joke, like you weren't tweeting about the stream, thinking you were tweeting about the stream, but now you tell me you're not tweeting about the stream.
Wasn't tweeting about the stream.
What the fuck is this? What are we doing?
Some very special news that people probably already know is Space Cop is back in stock.
What?
Space Cop Blu-rays are back in stock. And so I was just tweeting. Something people might... That's true. Something people might not know about me and Space Cop is I have the most on-screen roles in Space Cop. Barely beating out a plastic plant. But I went through the movie a couple times to double check that I have the most on-screen roles.
I'm going to say, though, I probably dominate when it comes to screen time.
Oh, of course, of course. You dominate when it comes to screen time. Mike and Jay dominate when it comes to off-screen roles, because obviously, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I am on screen in the widest variety of roles. So, almost all. I am one of all of those aliens. That's true. And so I wanted to tweet that out and, you know, to remind people that Space Cop is back in stock.
Some people who subscribed before we started.
Yeah.
You know, do some shout-outs now. Well, why not? I can do with that.
You can do whatever you want, Rich.
Do whatever I want. Yeah. Frosty Snooze, 18 months in a row.
Yeah.
Do you want to switch on over?
Oh, a Sausage Toes, 13 months in a row.
And was it A. Michelle, right? Or A. Michael? I always want to say Michael. A. Michelle. A. Michelle. Let's say A. Michelle.
I like A. Michelle. A. Michelle?
A. Michelle?
Yeah.
A. Michelle, 87! 17 months in a row.
And Knowledge Junkie. Thanks for subscribing. We appreciate it.
Does that mean I have mild dyslexia? Because I see that name, I want to say A. Michael. Is that what that is? Am I moving the A over in my brain?
A. Michael? What do you mean? No, it's you just want it to fit correctly.
Maybe. Cesarian Fart!
Oh, did I not update the stream?
And Theodore J. Hooker, 17 months in a row, thank you for subscribing.
Thank you.
Okay.
We appreciate it. So, we are not playing Punch Club, no matter what it says. I thought I updated the stream. Apparently, I did not. We are playing The Witness. The hot, hot, fresh. This is a hot, fresh, and new.
Poppin' fresh.
Poppin' fresh. Poppin' lockin'. All those we're doing all those things. We're playing The Witness. This is the new indie game from Jonathan Blow, famed creator of Braid. Kicker offer of the next wave of indie games. What?
All right, I have no idea what's going on, so great. I guess I'm walking forward.
I would also recommend walking forward.
I'm not running forward. I'm apparently going to like walk forward. I don't know.
Yeah.
Is there? What are the settings? Mouse speed.
Mouse speed 2D. Mouse softening.
Interesting. Okay. Or not interesting.
Okay.
Not interesting?
Not interesting.
Obviously, there are 2D segments and 3D segments would be my assumption.
Interesting.
All right.
Interesting. Rich is playing.
All right. Drag the thing over. Okay. I dragged the thing over.
You did it.
Oh, my God. Look at how... This is...
You know what? My preferred way to solve puzzles is just to slam my face right into it. Okay. Oh. All right.
Okay. Oh, my God. It's so colorful.
Ooh. Benjamino Free, if you forgot to ask for a signature, don't tell us. Send an email. to contact@redlettermedia.com.
Telling me Jack is gonna, you know, that's gonna do for you? Jack shit.
Big boat pile of nothing. So contact@redlettermedia.com. Say, hey, this is my name. If you have your order number, that'll help them find it.
Oh, well, I've been playing Dragon's Dogma, which I like. Mm-hmm. But, oh, this is so beautiful and colorful, comparatively speaking, isn't it?
Look at that.
It's like you walk into a world of color.
Look at that.
You walk out of your dreary fantasy world into a world of amazing colors.
Oh, it's so pretty. Oh, it's so pretty. You know what? Poiples. Well, Jack will shit on my copy of Space Cop, you know, if you pay enough.
If you really want that, we can make an arrangement.
Yeah? Interesting.
Oh, wait, I think I see. There's a puzzle thing. There's a thing here. There's a thing.
Oh, you have to power up all the things.
We got to power up all the things. We got to power up all the things. We got to do this.
That's right. Come with me and you'll see.
What?
A world of pure imagination.
Oh my god, what? What?
Take a trip.
It's a maze.
And you'll see.
It's so amazing.
To your... Nope.
Okay, I just wanted to see if you could block yourself, and you can.
You can block yourself.
All right, so where are we going here?
I guess that works, too.
I don't see it. Do you see it? I don't see it. I think we're blanked off.
You can probably start from the other
one.
Yeah,
we're... Oh, you know what? That's a good idea. That's a necessary idea. No, we're still... Wait. I see it.
Okay. Oh, sorry. Oh, no. But that... Oh, yep.
Wait. Yeah.
Yay! Puzzles! I like puzzles.
I like nothing.
Rich, can you confirm this will become an XCOM 2 channel for 2 weeks?
Probably.
Probably five.
Probably like a month.
You know, there's going to be a lot of XCOM 2, which also means that there's going to be a lot of gibbering for me, because I can only imagine it'll mostly be Rich.
Oh, my God!
Oh, my God, indeed.
My God!
Lord Belmont would like to say, I started watching Fargo because of you. Thank you very much. It's such a great show. I'm halfway through the second season. Fantastic. Absolutely. Fargo's great. I enjoyed the first season a lot more, but the second season's still great, too. Fargo. Everything Fargo.
Okay.
So now you have to do the other one, too.
Wait, was there... Oh, down there. Shit. Yeah.
Can you come off your path already? Like, you know, see where it would lead.
Wait, I work backwards from. Oh, sure. There we go.
Let's see here. Also, Anonymous says, hey, guys. I don't want to spoil that scene, but Anonymous was also telling us their favorite scene in Space Cop.
Is it my favorite scene?
What's your favorite scene without spoiling it?
It involved a choo-choo train.
No, it is not your favorite scene. It involves a very special guest star. Great job, Rich. Hope you guys have some better plans for Valentine's Day than Deadpool Zoolander. I might go see Deadpool. Lord Belmont also says, also, Rich, look into Homeworld, Deserts of Karak.
Why? I don't like real-time strategy games.
Mm-hmm.
I hate most every real-time strategy game.
Okay.
Most every. And you make a sequel to Homeworld, right?
Yeah.
Which the big thing was spaceships and rotating in like 3D space.
Yeah.
And then you make a sequel that takes place entirely on the ground, it looks like?
Yeah.
Not in space.
In a desert planet. Yeah.
What the fuck? What the fuck?
Right.
It's one of those things where it's like, what were you thinking? What were you thinking, young man?
What was we can't say what Rich's favorite scene is yet because spoilers. Because spoilers.
I hope I'm doing more than mazes.
I can only imagine there's more than mazes, right? What the fuck? Or maybe there's not. Who knows? Bing, bing. But, Burakat is asking about the Space Cop digital release. There is no definitive date for the Space Cop digital release. I can't say because I don't know. No.
What?
Oh, never mind. I thought I was like, wait a minute, you might have to do another puzzle later, so don't screw yourself. But no, it doesn't matter.
So what are they talking about?
Twitch Plays Pokemon says, it could have been cool if there was an underground aspect to it. Isn't it about scavenging or salvaging ships that crashed into the desert planet anyway? They're talking about Karak.
Yeah.
The Karak.
Do they agree with me, though, that it seems weird that you would follow up Homeworld with a game that takes place on the ground in the desert?
Yeah, where else are you going to go with it?
You just Ooh. Do more space, because that's the fun shit.
Ooh, look how pretty this is.
I want to build spaceships. I hate real-time strategy, and that's the only thing I liked about Homeworld 1 and 2.
Sure.
And now they took that away. What the fuck? What the motherfucking fuck, motherfucker? Right.
How long until Space Cop is on Netflix? Probably a very long time.
What is this? What is this? Oh, there's dots. You gotta do something with dots now. Ooh. Look at all the dots.
That's right, Mario. Dread is a wonderful movie. Congratulations on watching it. Everyone should watch Dread. It's a wonderful movie.
Ooh. Look at all these dots.
What are you doing?
I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, just getting dots? Dipping?
There's things on here now, and I don't know what they do. I'm assuming I'll figure it out.
Are you dipping dots? Mr. Shy Smile, I think you'll find out exactly.
Oh, my God!
I think you'll find out exactly what Rich and I think about Dragon's Dogma soon. We just shot something today in which we will explain in great detail our feelings for Dragon's Dogma. Overall, though, we can both say we feel very positively about it. That's the summation. So we don't hold you in anticipation.
What?
Oh, it didn't like that.
I don't know.
It did not like.
Was that a bomb? Did I set a bomb?
Anonymous would like to say, my name is Jack Beck of Germantown Police Department. Mr. Don Wilson, we'd like to ask you a few questions on your whereabouts the night of Friday. A tip has come our way saying you stole a load of cheese.
I can't get into
that. Oh, no, we're not donning.
You need a whole night for that.
We're not donning.
I can't just do that in spurts, goddammit.
Fearful Sludge Boy, yes, we played Invisible Ink after the updates. I know Rich liked it a lot more.
And I certainly can't do it while I'm playing a game.
What?
Don Wilson.
Oh, no. There's no way.
That's you impossible.
That. I kind of ran out of steam with Invisible Ink.
It's enjoyable for, you know, what I got out of it.
Yeah.
I like Invisible Ink.
But, yeah, we both played it after the...
Okay.
So you need to not hit those things, or you need to hit them.
I think I need to hit them both.
Oh, okay.
The response to that last one I passed, though, where it looked like it was physically impossible to hit them both.
Oh.
So I don't know what's going to happen.
Robododo, I cannot tell you what we think of The Witness so far. We have been playing for approximately 3 minutes. In these 3 minutes, we've done a lot of these puzzles. And I hope it goes somewhere. I am... going to go out on a limb and say I'm sure that it goes somewhere. Because it has to go somewhere, right?
It doesn't have to do anything it doesn't want to do.
It's
a free individual.
It is. That is true, and you are correct.
All right, Jack, how do I do this? What's the puzzle?
Huh?
How do I do this?
How do you get all of them?
Yeah. So I can't go back.
Right. Let me see. Oh, no, no, no. You go right first. Right, up, nope. Back, up. That one, now left, up. Oh, never mind. Maybe you were right. Go all the way down first. I can't do that. Oh, oh, no, no, I can't do. Oh, interesting.
Hmm.
Oh, how interesting.
Hmm.
Hmm. Hold on, wait. Go back to that. I want to see if I can figure it out.
Why am I playing? This game is already farty. This is totally your. This is me. This is you.
Here, you take this.
Here.
Give me this. Do you have your? Where's your board?
Oh, it's downstairs from when we did the thing with the thing.
Where's your wooden plank?
I'll find a plank. Hold on.
I need a wooden plank. This game is already farty. This is. I do enjoy. Okay, wait. How do I get over here? How do I get over here? Okay, here we go. Take a look. Oh, I got it. I got it. Rich doesn't even know how much. Oh, he doesn't even know how much I got it. I'm the one that should be playing these games, not Rich. I gotta do this though, with the mouse and the keyboard. I think Rich took the controller home. I don't even know if this game is supported by controllers. Oh, I think it's supposed to go in between the black and the white. So like this one, we're supposed to go here. Yeah. Am I supposed to segregate? This is all about segregation. Like this. I'm so on this. So on it. Oh. Oh, isn't that interesting? Rich has abandoned me also. Rich has abandoned me. Has unbanded me. Rich has unbanded me. You see that? It's pretty good. It's pretty good. What can I say? I mean, I'm pretty good. So we do the same thing. Boom. Up, down. Boom. Segregation. That's the message. It's not the message. It's just a puzzle. Just a puzzle, everybody. Settle down. Okay. Boom. Oh, no, no, no. This one. Boom. Okay, great. Let's look around the world a little bit. This is beautiful. Everything here is beautiful, and I love it. And I probably don't want to go down there. Can I jump? Can I jump? I cannot jump. Can I jump? J for jump? No, J does not jump. I cannot jump. Can I fall? Oh, I can't fall, actually. Look. Jump. Nope. Walking slowly around the world. Being by myself. La-di-da-di-da-di-di. Ooh, here's a puzzle.
Double puzzle. Ooh, double puzzle. Initiate.
Oh.
Look. It's my shadow. It's my shadow. That's the real puzzle.
Rich.
Yeah.
Did you bring a controller?
This is in my bag.
Is this game supported by controllers?
That's how you're more comfortable playing it.
That's how I'm more comfortable playing everything. Look what I discovered, Rich.
You have a shadow?
We have a shadow.
Nice.
We have a shadow, Rich.
So I guess I don't need that anymore, probably.
You don't need the board anymore.
Probably.
I'm hoping as I really, in general. Oh, thank you. I just prefer a controller. I know. Don't get into a whole thing, everybody.
To each their own. Anything with aiming.
I would probably far prefer to have mouse and keyboard. Actually, I didn't really talk about this during the review, so I'll talk about it here.
About what?
Dragon's Dogma.
Okay.
Because you can use a bow, right?
Yeah.
Most of the game's melee.
Yeah.
The melee stuff with the sword, I'm more comfortable with the controller, but with the bow, I'd use a sword. So I was playing a lot of the game with...
How do you get to the menu?
Hit escape. Use the arrow keys.
You're an arrow key.
So I was playing like part of the game with like the controller, and then I had my mouse next to me. When I dragged the bow out, my hand would go over to the mouse real quick.
Uh-huh.
So I could aim with the mouse. You know, because I started off as the fighter class, so I got used to using the controller.
Yeah.
What's going on?
I stopped the game so I could restart it now that the controller's plugged in to see if it recognized the controller.
Okay.
I'm hoping this works. There we
go. For the bow, I use a mouse. Did I misspeak? I use the mouse for the bow.
You misspeak.
I misspeak all the time. People know that about me.
Ha. Yes. There we go. Controller. Whoa. Now I is ready to play. Is the someone tell me if you can see the game. I'm pretty sure you can. Okay, hold on. Settings.
Wow. Just watching you use a controller to navigate in the first person perspective just gave me like a mild headache for a split second. Mild headache. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Subtitles? Yes.
Oh my god. How do you scroll this thing?
Whoa. Yeah, we're not.
Do you not. This wants to highlight. Do you have to.
What?
Do two fingers? What do you. How do you scroll?
I don't know.
How do you do things with your. This. I don't get touch. Why do people like touch anything? It's horrible. It's horrible and it's imprecise. And I hate it. I hate it.
You want to scroll up or down? But
I just whenever I want to scroll. Yeah. When I need, if I want to like see something,
you have to go to the scroll bar.
Okay, so this doesn't function like other scroll things. This is like a different.
Yeah.
But my fat finger doesn't want to recognize I'm on the
just
bar right.
The
I hate it.
Just go to the bottom.
I hate it.
I'm sorry. Hold on. I'm not quite there yet.
Actually titling a stream about a slow puzzle game with a reference to one of the most high-speed action films of the 21st century is kind of a dick move.
We said not a Mad Max reference. So... that's what we said. All right. Do-do-do-do-do. Oh, here we go. Here's puzzle number one. So these are like mirror puzzles. So we have to like... bink. Oh, God. Oh, God damn it. All the way up. All the way up.
What's going on?
Whoa, too much up. Too much up. Oh, just tinkering with the settings.
So how's your art game?
So far, you know, it's very arty. It's fuck you. Settings, hold on. Back down. Back down.
Rich confirm for old man. Is this something I really have to feel bad about? Yeah, no shit. I'm an old man. We know this.
Yeah.
That's the thing. That's just me. That's the thing about me.
Did you not know that about Rich? Because he's kind of an old man. You know, I like puzzles.
This is exciting.
Rich, I like puzzles.
This is so exciting.
I like them. I enjoy puzzles. Can we go together?
No. This is neat. This double at once thing. This is kind of neat.
I'm not going to apologize for enjoying puzzles.
Bing.
Oh, snap dam. This one. Do. Oh, no.
Wait. You're going to fuck yourself up on the ones on the outer edges, though. Because I can already see in one you've. Wait, no, that one can get through. I take it back.
Oh.
Oh, there's two outer ones. You don't have to do those?
Apparently not.
All right.
Unless. Do I? No, apparently not.
Oh, never mind. Never fucking mind.
Okay, so I opened that up, and now we follow the glowy worm snake to more puzzles. Follow the glowy worm snake. Puzzle. Oh, look. Apacito. Apacito, pasito.
This is like a slightly more difficult version of Alien Isolation.
Ah!
I think that's a fair criticism.
Except, like, no. I guess
it
is.
At least they're upfront, though, about the game being about opening doors. What the fuck? Do we have a new noise for that?
Okay, so did you see that?
This?
Nope.
Oh my god, what happened?
The square.
The square? What does the square do? Why is there a square?
Because there's a square.
Where do we live off? Are all of these red? Except for the ones at the top. Is this one red? Oh, yeah, it was Don Wilson one. We did read that. Never mind.
Yeah.
All right, Anonymous says... Mr. Evans, my name is Jack Beck of Germantown, PD. I'd like to ask you a few questions. Someone...
Oh, my God!
Someone tipped us off saying you sold stolen cheese and wouldn't sell the Munster. You let my giraffe babies die. Someone really wants to see Don Wilson tonight. The Real Vion says, I finally saw Space Cop. It was great.
It's great. Thanks, The Real Vion.
I guess the thing that's not in the movie, would that be considered spoilers?
It was not in the movie?
It was a thing in the trailer that's not in the movie. It was in the trailer as a joke.
What?
No, that's if I say it. Hmm? No?
It was not in the movie.
Okay. Except spoilers, there was no giant blue light which shot up into the sky, despite being in the trailer.
That's true.
I expect to see it the extended edition. Yeah, that was. I think that was purely a trailer joke.
Yeah, because all trailers have the giant blue light.
Do we have to dub ourselves a lot for Space Cop? I got that vibe for quite a few of the scenes. That was a lot of background noise places we're shooting. Can't always help it.
Yep. That happens. Obviously, you know, you try to make it sound as natural as possible, but you know, it happens. Let's see here. Do 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 do. Ooh, look at this. Look at this puzzle.
Oh my god.
It's all warped.
Oh my god.
Oh, I love it.
It's like a crazy headache come to life.
I love it. Like this. Oh, God. Yeah, no, so far this is us playing the first, you know, 10 minutes. So, back this way. So where does this glowy snake go?
I have to imagine there'll be more than just what you're doing over and over again.
I don't. Maybe not. Maybe it's just puzzles.
Maybe it's beautiful just scenery and bland puzzles.
Well, I'm sure they get more difficult, but you know, it's puzzles. Ooh! I found some more puzzles, Rich.
Okay. I'm super excited for you.
Thinking? Are they thinking of reviewing Space Cop for half the bag? No, I don't. I don't think they could.
It'd be kind of masturbatory, wouldn't it? Really?
Reviewing your own movie?
Yeah.
Incredibly.
Up. Hit the one. Oh, wait, you gotta get that one.
Yeah. We have to get this one
up,
first.
Right, up, left, up. Oh.
Oh, wait. Here we go. I got it.
No. Up, back, left. There you go.
That's the controller.
There you go.
That was just the controller. I got it.
Through the gate, up the...
Oh, did I miss one? Oh, there it is. There's more snakies.
Twitch Plays Pokemon says, I heard it's 20 hours long, so I expect the puzzles to get really crazy later in the game.
Oh, I can only imagine.
Is it the same type of puzzle over and over again? Or do they ever do anything, like, different?
I would assume it's the same type that just get harder and harder. How do I get down there? Oh, here we go. Where do you start? Right here.
This is a love letter to Myst. Well, no wonder I'm not loving it.
Not a fan of Myst?
I hate Myst. I hate Myst so much. Obviously, this is too simple for it to be that simple.
Oh, I get it. Look at the rocks.
Oh, that's kind of clever.
I think that's very clever. Oh, yeah.
All right, where are we at here? Ugh. All right, recruit more pimps for you, says. I hold a weekly best of the worst party with some friends. Already seen Troll 2 in Miami Connection, and we are looking for suggestions, preferably with blood debts ending caliber ridiculousness. Ridiculousness. Let's see. What's really good? Well, we enjoyed, as you probably know, watching Deadly Prey.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you need to see Deadly Prey.
Deadly Prey is a quality one.
Yeah, that is very
cool. Neil Breen, anything.
Mm-hmm. Well, no, you can't start with Neil Breen. I think
you
Neil
can. Your brain would melt.
Your brain would melt. You need other crazy first.
What's crazier than Neil Breen? Just doesn't make any sense. Go all the way around the edge.
Because there's nothing?
I don't know.
These are all the rock ones. All
right, can you look at it from the other side?
Nice, Rich. No.
Oh.
Well, but
there.
I think that...
Unless you look at it from a different angle. Right?
I don't think you can look at it from a different angle.
You got to get that one first.
Yeah.
What was the one we watched with Len that had the ridiculous ending with the wheelchair getting knocked over and the guy in drag?
Was that Ninja
Vengeance?
Or Ninja 3 the Domination?
No, that was the one with the possessed woman.
Then, yes. Then
I think it was Ninja Vengeance.
Ninja Vengeance.
Telegon says, Mr. Wilson, we know what you did to Mr. Trump's hairpiece. The money is in Colombia. They're conspiring to get Don Wilson back. Look, if I'm not feeling up to it, it's going to be a letdown. I gotta be in character for that shit to work.
Everybody loves Don Wilson.
So do you want to ruin it?
All right, hold on. If it is this one. Oh, I'll get down.
You know what all just tells me? That I'm not interesting enough. And I agree. But it's very sad to hear someone else say it.
Aw.
Very sad. All right, there's a trick here that we're missing, Jack.
There it is. It was the rocks over there. So you just kind of had to see over there and see that it was like a medium, small, tall, medium.
Oh.
So.
Oh.
You just had to look at those rocks. That was the trick. I figured it out.
I kind of hate that trick.
Yeah. Oh. What?
How much do we have to tip to get Don Wilson for the rest of the stream?
Oh, God, the rest of the stream.
A single $2,000 donation. A single $2,000 donation.
Wow.
And I can't even guarantee it'll be good, Don Wilson, because I'm just not. I'm not. I don't know if I'm up to it. But I'll try for $2,000 one single donation. And before some rich autist does it, if they do, then good. I'll buy some shit with that money. Rich, what is on my shirt? Superman and Batman. Yeah, that's what's on my shirt.
You know. Just Superman and Batman.
Rich, you know that will happen, and then we'll have that whole Sonic Bidding War situation. I don't know what the Sonic Bidding War situation is.
Sonic Bidding War?
Yeah. Are they calling Planet Freedom Planet Sonic? Is that what they're doing? Because they're similar. But if I get $2,000, it's great. That's great.
Oh my God!
Is it $2,000? Is it $2,000? No. No, it's $2. It's only $2. Tractor says, Jack, make sure to check out... the board game / iPhone app Ascension, Chronicle of the Godslayer. Rich, I'm going to the bar with some friends soon. Any tips to pick up girls? I'll report back. I really don't. I am the worst person you can ask for tips on girls, because I'm going to tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
I've only ever met with Karen. She's been I've known her since high school. Mm. She's been in. So I never went through all that.
You never went through getting girls?
I ended up with my high school sweetie. That's fine. That's all fine. Lord Belmont says, I was ecstatic to see Bruce Campbell in Fargo Season 2. What?
Sanctuary Chronicle of the God Slayer.
Oh, Jack is checking
out. I put
Ascension: Chronicle of the God Slayer. And then Lord Belmont says, I was ecstatic to see Bruce Campbell in Fargo Season 2. Besides Fargo, what other more violent, dark shows would you recommend? Anonymous says, I'm sorry, Rich. I tried.
One thing at a time. What other dark show?
Oh, I guess I should.
One thing at a time.
They're showing up quick and furious. Now, this is one single donation, you know. I'm not doing this for the nickel and diming up to 2,000. Though, if you want to do that, I'm not going to stop you. But I'll only do Dom Wilson All Night for a single $2,000 donation. I went too low last time. It's got to mean something.
So I bookmarked Ascension. Thank you. I am looking for a new app game. Okay. So dark shows like Fargo is what was mentioned. I mean, like Fargo is tough. Fargo's so fucking good. Do you watch anything dark like Fargo? Have you seen Fargo?
Define dark. Would you call Ash versus Evil Dead dark?
No, it's goofy.
I don't know that I watch much that's dark. I'll think on it and come back to it. Anonymous says, I'm sorry, Rich. Tried to cheer you up with a joke about a truck full of cheese that was stolen Friday night. Was in the Milwaukee News. I wasn't trying to put you in the Don Wilson spot. Anonymous, it's all cool. I actually hadn't heard about the truck full of cheese being stolen.
Oh, is that why you keep mentioning the cheese?
I thought that was just like somebody wanted to start a Don Wilson bit. Yeah, no, I had no idea that was an actual thing. It sounds like a Don Wilson scheme.
It does sound like a Don. Okay,
we're gonna store this truck full of cheese, all right?
And then we'll age it and sell it on the black market.
I have the world's largest bowl of nachos, but we need some cheese. As a taste, what Got you it. Can get for Ooh. $2,000.
Terrible, Rich.
R. Miller says... For the $2, for the Come to Orlando fund, not that you will, I just want to bring the gag back.
Oh, sure, sure. The come to here fund gag?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That's a fine gag. It's fine. Wait, where does this one go? Lost track.
It's dark shows.
Dark shows... I mean, you know, it's really tough to compare with Fargo. I know everybody likes Better Call Saul. Did this just ends here?
Go back. What are the follow your lines?
No, this is where it ended.
All right, well, that probably opened up something further back then.
It did.
You went past.
Well, wait. Look, there's a little cord. Do I have to do one on this side too? I'm asking you, and you don't know.
I obviously don't know. What? Cesarian Fart says, hey guy, I got my copy of Space Cop last week and screened it for my parents. Oh my god. I think they finally disowned me.
Yay!
Keep up the great work.
Nice.
Well, you should have known that would be a bad idea. Come on. Come on.
There's like a little cord.
Rick and Morty isn't that dark. Are you kidding me? Rick and Morty is a blend of dark and light. Rick and Morty is totally dark humor. I would categorize that as dark.
Rick and Morty?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You've seen some finally?
I have seen some.
What do you think?
I saw the first season.
Okay. What do you think of the first season?
I think it's all right.
Okay.
I'm not blown away by it. I actually, it's a little too, and I totally get it that this is their style, but it's like they're a little, it's a little too like freeform improv-y.
Mm-hmm.
And I totally get it. That's how they write it, and that's what makes it so fun. I also cannot stand Rick's burp talking. It grates on my ears every time he burp talks or like belches in the middle of talking. I hate it.
Astro Pigo says Rick and Morty isn't dark. Dude, the ending of an episode is Rick trying to kill himself and failing because he passes out right before the machine blows his head up.
Right.
It gets dark in a good, funny way, mm-hmm. but it still goes dark.
Rick and Morty's real, man. They get real. They get really real, man. What the fuck?
They ruin the world in one episode. Mm-hmm. Like, the world gets overrun with monsters because of an experiment that gets out of hand.
Uh-huh.
So they find an alternate dimension where they die, and then they bury their own corpses and just take over in the new alternate world.
Yep.
That's dark.
That's season one, by the way.
It's funny, but it's dark.
Am I not here yet? Oh, no. Okay, I can do this now. Oh. What?
Oh my God!
Ragged Scribe says, Rich, could you ask Jack if he'd watch my 10-minute comedy skit and give me editing tips? Here's the link. By the way, love Space Cop.
I guess here's the thing. I will, but I will give you tips. And some people don't deal with criticism well. So I'm blocked here. Actually, I don't know if I have to open up a different thing first. So
interesting.
Maybe I'll go over here and see if I missed something. Oh yeah, I did miss something. Okay. Save. Was that a tip? Did he tip us asking
yeah.
for?
Yeah.
Okay. Then I'll have it. Yeah, I'll give it a look. Unless you want me to watch it right now. In which case, that might be difficult.
Jack confirmed for ice cold.
Yes, I am.
Well, you know, if you're asking for tips,
that's the thing.
You have to give the advice. If you chicken out, then you're doing nobody any favors.
Yeah. But, you know, some...
No, it was good!
There are some people who, like... There are some people who ask for like, you know, oh, could you watch this and let me know what you think? And then, you know, you spend time and you try to give constructive criticism and they don't want to hear it. All they wanted to hear was that they were great. You know, like, no, yeah. I just want you to see it and tell me I was great. It's like, oh, no, that's, you want me to.
One Small Ball says, hey, guys, got my copy of Space Cop Monday.
Oh,
funny as all fuck. And since Rich is wearing a Batman shirt, here's my dog dressed like the Bat. There's a link. Nice. I guess we can check that out later.
Cool.
Speaking of the Bat,
I got sent
this today, and I read it. Batman and the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which are two things I like.
Mm-hmm.
And Freddie Williams did the art. Cool guy.
It's pretty good.
It's pretty good. I haven't been in a comic book store in 5 years, but I want to read the rest of those issues when they're out. I'll have to track down Batman Ninja Turtles.
I got them digitally. I got them digitally. So I could just have you log on to Comixology. I like that Comixology. No. Oh, wait. Yeah, no. I did it wrong.
Down?
No.
Yeah.
No, because we have to end here.
Oh, wait. Oh, sorry.
And so they're going opposites.
The trick might be, go all the way over. Wait, maybe the... Yeah, no. Because then you'll miss that one. There has to be a trick.
Oh, of course.
Gobbledygook says, tipping 2,000 for Don Wilson. He only tipped 6,132, which is a lot. Which is a lot. Also, did you know you could play as Superman or Batman in DC Universe Online for the PS4? It's free, you fucks. Never gets old.
It's free, you fucks.
I mean, 61 is like $2,000 in rubles.
I got it.
How many rubles? For $61, I talk like Russian man for a minute or two. It's good, no? Yes. Maybe.
You're making me run the gamut of emotions.
No. Yes, then over, then up.
Then over again.
Just this guy you know says nobody exists on purpose. Nobody belong anywhere. Everybody's going to die. Come watch TV. Just watch GI and FF recently. Really fun.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Bring back Jack as Jesus. This is tax deductible, right?
Absolutely, 100%. That's right. Oh, that was in season one, too, when Morty's sister was, like, contemplating her existence. She's like, they dropped some knowledge on Rick and Morty. Oh, yes. Wait, so are they telling me that I need to get the opposite ones?
Maybe.
No. Okay. Oh.
So how do you do this? How is this even?
Oh, okay. Well, the first one I touch is blue. I touched the other one last time.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Okay, so this should be... Oh.
Richest villain in new Die Hard.
Oh, that makes me sad.
Oh my god!
Did the guys already weigh in on the Revenant? Has Bear! I like Bear.
You like Bear? I have not seen it. From what two assholes told me in a review of theirs I watched, I would probably not enjoy it.
How did we get Russian rich? And how does anything happen? Just fucking go with it. Not everything has to be for a reason. Why did that happen? Why does this happen? Why are things the way they are? Who cares? Anonymous says, would you say waking up inside a dead horse is Oscar worthy or just a good end to a good night?
A little bit of both. A little bit of both.
What's the meaning of life? I don't know. Fuck do you care?
Everyone knows the meaning of life. It's just far simpler than anyone cares to think. You know what the meaning of life is? Fuck. Make a baby. Meaning of life is make a baby.
That woman, make baby.
Yep.
That makes for great night.
Does it? This is it. Make baby. Have woman. No more. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. What?
Favorite Stargate episode? The one where I've never watched Stargate a single day in my life.
Oh, that's an interesting choice.
It's my favorite episode.
That's an interesting choice, Rich. You've never seen a single Stargate episode?
No. Huh? I hated the movie. It's like, the movie is just stupid. Why would I want to see the show. I hear the show's good. Uh-huh. So whatever. Not like I haven't been wrong before. Yes. No, down.
No.
I guess that works too. I believe I had another way.
Well, I needed to get the one over there in this one.
Yeah, I had that in my head. I knew what was going on. Bitch.
You bitching me? You bitching this?
Bitch. You're gonna have to step off there, bitch. I tell you what.
Favorite XCOM enemy. Probably not gonna be a popular choice. Thin Men. Thin Men. Because early on in the game, in the early months in XCOM are the best part of the game, are just absolutely terrifying enemies that will fuck your shit up.
Uh-huh.
And then when you get better equipment and you get better in the game and you just start slaughtering them, it's very satisfying. Hmm. So Thin Men.
Hmm. Thin Mints. Interesting.
I've come so close to a perfect XCOM playthrough.
Mm-hmm.
My XCOM Holy Grail is a classic Iron Man playthrough where that's the classic is the difficulty. Iron Man is where you can't reload an old save.
Oh, sure.
Where I don't lose a single country and don't lose a single soldier. There's a spot where you get technology good enough. You don't really have to worry. The game gets a lot easier.
Uh-huh.
A Thin Man always manages to take out either a squatty or a rookie.
I'm sorry.
Before I get there.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Ooh, let's look at your yellow's weird. Do you have to do something to activate your yellow, or is this just some kind of graphical glitch?
It could be a graphical glitch, or it could be that these yellows are just weird.
Glotch.
Also could be a glotch. These yellows just might be weird.
XCOM is a puzzle shooter. Not really. Puzzles are pre-generated. XCOM is a tactical thing. You're making tactical decisions.
A puzzle
shooter. There's multiple solutions.
Adorable.
Puzzle. You're weighing gains and losses. That's tactics. It's not puzzle-y, really. You use your brain like you do in a puzzle game, but...
They might be being funny.
I don't know. They've said that over and over again.
They might be being funny because this is a puzzle game. I don't know. You know what? I also just don't know. I don't know who's doing...
No player should ever lose a soldier. You have a save and reload button. Don't play the game that way. You're doing it wrong.
What is that called? Save scrumming?
Save scumming.
Save scumming?
The glory of XCOM is just dealing with that loss, the glorious soldier you loved. That's the beauty of it.
Oh, by the way, look what's happening here. The yellow... This is actually really clever. Look, the yellow has been getting lighter and lighter.
Yeah.
And then here...
You can't even see it.
You can't even see it.
Oh, I get it. Oh, no.
That's... So you just kind of have to mentally...
That just seems miserable.
Oh, wait.
How could you stand that? Up.
Yeah, it's like this. Yeah. Because the yellow also goes opposite, you know, the blue.
Ugh.
Yeah. Ugh.
Rich, do you play Hearthstone? No.
Done. No.
Yeah. If you don't answer that, I'm going to say that question 50 more times, mm-hmm. even though I don't have an interesting answer to the question. So you just got to nip it in the bud, Jack.
No.
No. Nope. The answer is no.
No.
What the fuck game is this? This game is called Witness.
Witness.
It's
basically Myst, but instead of like point and click based puzzles, you have these little 2B puzzles.
Where are all the war boys? I don't understand.
Oh, I get it.
I'm a joke.
Witness.
Rich Jack, apart from the obvious, what are some games you sunk an inordinate amounts of time into? Well, I think everyone knows of it. XCOM.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Uh-huh.
I have a shocking amount of hours in the wildly unpopular Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game. What's it called? Out of the Shadows?
Out of the Shadows, yeah.
Which everyone shits on. Uh-huh. I think mostly just because co-op is broken, and I don't give a shit about that.
Right.
Because I'm a single-player guy. There we go. And I think the game is a good hybrid between a Batman-style fighter and, like, a Ninja Gaiden-style combo fighter.
Uh-huh.
It's a nice hybrid. Wildly unpopular choice, though.
That I think that is surprising. Mm-hmm. I think most people will be surprised to hear that.
Jack?
And everybody knows what mine is. It's TF2. I have...
They want one that's surprising. One that you haven't heard us talk about.
Do I have
Do you have just a lot of hours in? Could be game maybe like 15 years ago.
Right.
And you haven't thought about it much since. Like another one for me, Maximo. Old PlayStation 2 game.
Sure.
And its sequel. Inordinate amount of hours in. Same for the Zone of the Enders games.
Mm-hmm.
And I played No More Heroes a fuck ton of times.
I probably have, like, as far as old school games are concerned, probably the game I have the most amount of hours in is Turtles in Time for the Super Nintendo.
Mm-hmm.
That's a game that you can beat, like, if you're hauling, you can beat in 20 minutes, a half an hour, and I've just played it so many fucking times. Love that game. It's a great game.
WTF is Maximo. Maximo is an unofficial spiritual sequel to the Ghosts and Goblins games. Where you're some kind of knighty kind of guy who runs around only, and you slay monsters. Only Maximo is 3D, whereas the Ghosts and Goblins games were insanely hard 2D platformers.
You know, you're a knighty kind of guy.
You get hit and your armor flies off and you're in your boxer shorts running around. So you find more armor.
I think that's the thing that people would recognize about it the most is the knight in the boxer shorts.
But what that game did great, and I think most people hated it, but I kind of liked it, was you had a shield in that game.
Uh-huh.
But your shield could get broken. You could only block like 10 times. And instead of just being like playing that game like a turtle, uh-huh. You just held down the block button. You had to be judicial about how you blocked. I kind of like that. New TMNT game looks great. It looks shallow. It looks flashy, and I imagine it's going to be a button masher. But that's going on very little. I hopefully am wrong. It reminded me too much of their Transformers game.
It looks a lot like the Transformers game,
and that's very mashy. It's not very deep at all. But we'll see. Hopefully I'm horribly wrong. I don't think the most recent Transformers game was Platinum's best game by far. I played it once and then I kind of just completely forgot about the Transformers game.
Yeah. Look what they're doing here. You solve these puzzles.
Yeah.
And then these are mirrors.
Okay.
So you just have to like remember.
Oh, you can't see where it is.
Yeah. Oh, I think I just got a little bit wrong. I think it was like, that's it.
Dark Souls 3 is coming out soon. If you think DS1 felt a little dated, 3 looks to be a great game coming off of Bloodborne. Are you guys going to check it out? Probably yes.
Yeah, I mean, maybe.
Why would you not after loving Bloodborne?
Because the thing that made me love... Whoa.
The setting of Bloodborne is great. I'm not as into that as I am the weird, you know, medieval thing, sure.
Right.
But the gameplay of Bloodborne is just awesome. It's not bad in the other Dark Souls games either. But for some reason, I haven't gone back to play those and just play Bloodborne.
Yeah, but I think that part of the reason that I do that is because of the setting of Bloodborne. I think, do I do this? That's how I did it.
Rich, which game would you say is Platinum's best? Well, I'm not going to lie and say I've played a metric shit ton of their games. Like, I've never played Bayonetta.
A metric shit ton.
Yeah. I've never played the Bayonetta games. And sorry, I haven't, but I still haven't gotten around to the Metal Gear one they did. So, by default, my answer is Vanquish, which is, like, one of my favorite games of all time.
Do you hear that, Rich?
Yeah.
You know what that is?
What is it?
Time to stand up.
You go and do that.
I'm going to stand up.
You stand up. I'm going to
Everybody,
check.
We've been streaming for about an hour.
I'm going to check the phone message I got. That's all I'm going to do.
We've been streaming for about an hour, and as you guys know, this is something that usually I lax on, so I set my phone timer. It's been an hour. Everybody, stand up. If you're sitting down, you've been sitting down for an hour, stand up.
Stretch it out. Stretch out them legs. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Everybody standing?
So important to stand up once an hour. Yep, stand up, walk to the kitchen, get another beer. That counts as standing up, absolutely. Abso-freaking-lutely. I'm going to set a timer here for another hour. You know why? It's really important to stand up.
Mm-hmm.
Really important to get that blood moving. Ah, there we go. Sleeping's different. Everybody knows that. Don't be dumb. When you sleep, you don't need to worry about walking around. But when you just sit, your legs, they atrophy. It's terrible for you. Okay.
Rich, what is on...
For some reason, I'm the worst at these.
Rich, what is on your shirt? Obviously, as you can see, these are two lesbians going at it. Yeah, that's what's on my shirt.
What? Oh, fuck you. Oh, I'm just the worst at these, Rich. Well, here's what I'm going to do. This isn't cheating.
Are you really playing this the whole stream?
Looks like it.
See, Jack thought this would go over like gangbusters, because this is the big hot game.
This is the hot new indie title. It's the hot new indie title, guys.
Can we put it to a vote? Is Jack completely 1,000% wrong about that?
About this being that? I'm not wrong about it being the hot new indie title. Like, if people don't like it.
Yeah.
Where did it go?
Did it know you draw the thing? No, it's just fucking with you.
Where did it go? Did I only get one shot at that? What the fuck? What the fuck, guy?
Let me check to see if I got that $2,000 donation yet. No. I'm still waiting. Still waiting on a $2,000 single donation to do Don Wilson's voice for the rest of the stream. You have to redo the previous one.
Do I?
That's what I'm being told.
Oh.
What the fuck?
Oh, shit. I'm not going to remember this. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. All right, great. Okay, so. Don't mind me. This is perfectly legal.
I'm guessing if he gets $2,000, the stream will end 2 minutes later. I wouldn't be that big a prick.
That would be really prickish.
That'd be a dick move.
That'd be prickish.
And no one would ever show up to a stream again.
Yeah.
And you know what? You'd be right to do that.
That would be prickish as fuck.
Do you guys have an email address or something where I can send you my hot new indie title?
Absolutely.
Was it previously recorded at What is it?
It's prereq.
Prereq.
At redlettermedia.com. P-R-E-R-E-C at redlettermedia.com. All right, hold on. Don't mind me. I'm just cheating.
Just take a picture.
It's more fun if I draw it. How about that?
It's also more time consuming.
I don't give a fuck. What?
King Vidiot, I think in reference to the $2,000 one-time donation, yeah. One single donation for Don Wilson rest of the stream, says, shouldn't the price lower with less time remaining in the stream?
Oh.
Hey, I don't make the rules.
That's true. Rich does not
I don't make the rules.
He does not make the rules. If it's one thing about Rich Evans, I know. He does not make the rules. Okay.